Kate.
I saw your taxi drive up.
Oh my God, you were
there. I saw you at the hub today, so I know you were there.
Okay, then I'll get you a towel. They're sleeping. Then I'll make you some coffee.
This is a nice house.
Yeah. Nice mortgage, too.
What's your daughter's name?
Katie.
She's beautiful.
She's a handful.
We have a pro team in there in Nashville.
Yeah. Oh my God, get this. So they used to be in Houston. They were the Oilers, and now they're the Titans.
Houston Oilers are now the Tennessee Titans.
Yeah, and that's not all. Last year, we went to the Super Bowl.
I missed that.
Yeah, you would have died. We almost won by 1 yard. One lousy yard right at the end. Hey, so I've got 2% whole milk, low fat. I don't have any half and half. I know that's what you like.
No, that's okay. Black's fine. So whatever happened to you becoming a professor and Dr. Kelly Lovett?
Yeah, when your plane went down, everything just kind of went on hold. I think about taking it up again, though.
Why couldn't I? To give you this. I'm sorry, it's a little banged up. I took the picture, it was faded.
I want you to have it, I gave it to you.
No, no, it's a family heirloom. You should keep it.
This is everything that I have. From when the plane went down until now. They don't even know what caused the accident. I mean, probably some mislabeled hazardous material caught fire. That's where they found you. You had drifted 500 miles. This is where your island was. It's about 600 miles south of the Cook Islands. These are all the search grids. Ships went back and forth for weeks looking for you.
I never should have got on that plane. I never should have gotten out of that car.
I wanted to do something. Come here.
You kept our car?
That's a big call. This is so weird. We had a lot of good memories in that car.
Two very good memories.
That trip to the car. Can I have it back? I mean, can I drive?
It's your car!
Thanks, because my, looks like my taxi just left.
Yeah, just let me get a couple things out the back.
Sure. So, you gonna have more kids?
I don't know. I mean, it's confusing right now.
Vinewood, I mean, with Rich. You should.
Chuck, listen. I always knew you were blood. They told me that I had to quit saying it though, but I didn't want to. I love you.
I love you too. More than you'll ever know.
Chuck.
Is that a mistake? When you said, can I have it back? Or is that a line?
It's not a line. I
it was great.
Yeah, it was. Yeah,
it was a, that was a wonderful moment, man.
Yeah.
And you did what I always ask actors to do, is to get through it. To train yourself to not break a take. And you went, you know, can I have it back? And you're like, oh, that's a mistake. Like,
is
I shouldn't
that
say that. The way you played it was, can I have it back?
That was my thought.
And it just came out. But it came out as the character. It didn't come out as Clint making a mistake. It came out as the character.
Well, I try and think of what I'm thinking, the subtext, and then the subtext verbalized.
Well, yeah, and then we do the subtext exercise all the time to do that. And it was a wonderful little happy accident that kind of, for me, put the scene into overdrive. It was something that was that there was so much underneath what you guys were doing today, that was like you really put the scene went into fifth gear. You did all the work I asked you to do. You put together the book. Didn't it change it?
Yeah.
What a great moment, Jessica, when you were talking about the search grids. And you actually had something to refer back to. The thing that was fantastic about it was that you were using this piece. You kept on using the scrapbook that you had put together, and you were showing. I was looking here, and they were looking here. But what you're saying is, I was looking for you. I didn't give up on you. I didn't. It's not my fault. It's not my fault. It's not my fault. I was trying.
Yeah.
And it really fed you so nicely all the way through the scene. Because you had a prop that was specific,
mm-hmm.
and the first time you did it, it just didn't make any sense. You weren't referring to anything. There wasn't any sweat. There wasn't any blood in that thing that you were using. I don't even know what it was. It was it was nothing.
No, it was this notebook. It was just empty.
Yeah. So that by the time you got to the line, you said you'd be right back.
Mm-hmm.
It was really the end of the relationship. It was the end of holding the torch. By the time you got to that, and it's like I had done the best that I could. And you know, the world kept on turning. And you also did something that was marvelous. You, when he first came in, you were touching him. Like you found all these opportunities to put your hands on him.
Mm-hmm.
And I almost lost it for a second because when I was sick back in 2009, my sister lives on the East Coast, and she got married. Her husband was killed in 2001, and she got remarried, and I hadn't seen her in a little bit, and I went to the wedding, and when I first went to the wedding, it was after I had cancer and I was sick, and she kept on doing that, you know. When I saw her, she was like, "So you're okay? You're okay?" And she kept on like making sure that I was whole. And so, on a very human level, that was very real to me. Mm-hmm. And I don't know how that affected you. How did that affect you, Clint?
Well, I tried to make it feel like I haven't really been touched by anybody but myself. Not a joke. I've had no other senses, so to be touched is kind of weird. I was like...
And I was almost aggressive with it, too,
yeah.
You know, with the towel and everything,
yeah.
Kind of in your...
Made me feel kind of strange, but I liked it, of course.
Right.
Yeah.
Right. And how much did you want to kiss her when she was just looking at after the embrace and you looked down on her? How much did you want
to
kiss her?
I wanted to, but I would be doing her a disservice if I
She's
didn't.
Another man's wife?
Yeah. Yeah.
She's not yours anymore.
Yeah.
But I felt the urge.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that's what was most successful about this scene, was that all of those things, all of the unspoken words and the embrace that was so full but then couldn't be full,
mm-hmm.
the kiss that wanted to happen but couldn't happen,
mm-hmm.
the proof, I keep on going back to that. This
mm-hmm.
is proof that how much I loved you. Wonderful work, guys.
Mm-hmm.
Well done.
Thank you.
Okay, that's lunch.